Do you have a lot of contractors? Good. That means this video is going to be very useful to you. Because at Softr, we actually created a very nice contractor portal template that allows you to take all the different stuff that you have to communicate with your contractors in one simple place. As always, if you want to check out the different templates we have, make sure to go to softr.io/templates. And if you want to preview this before implementing it, you have the ability to do so right by clicking there on that, pressing sign in, and then using one of these different test users to get an insight into how it works. So there's essentially two user groups that function inside of this template. One of them is going to be a subcontractor view. So if we click on this, we'll take a look right here. Let's say, for example, that I was James McDowell. You'll see that we have the ability to click go to your dashboard as a subcontractor. And in the subcontractor dashboard, it aggregates the total amount of billed dollars, the hours, and total jobs, as well as the amount of completed jobs. So as you can see on the bottom here, we have a list of various houses that are in another database called jobs, right? And within here, all of these different jobs, if we click on them, go to specific details pages that showcase where the house is, the status pending of the jobs, the start and end date of them, what type it is, so like weekly mowing, how much total billed and logged hours and estimated hours are on it. It actually has a map block, which is very nice. So it showcases this Google map, gives a description of the job, has an attachment section here for any items that are needed. And then as a contractor, I can essentially log time on this specific project. And then I can filter by seeing whether the timesheets have been paid or they're outstanding as well. So if I click on that information, you can see that it ends up sending us to an outstanding view. 4431 Trussell Road, and then we can link back to the actual job itself. So this is essentially the timesheet. If I click on timesheets, I'll see all the different timesheets that I have, the status of payment, so whether it's outstanding or been paid, the job that it came from, and then this is information on, as you can see in the back end, this is a formula that grabs together things like the date, the type, and then the job, so at 8510 Vernon Street, and then the address. So I really like the way that this aggregates everything together. So the timesheets essentially allow for basic things to be input, like how many hours they are, and then they roll up all the different things within there. So for example, for any of these jobs, if I were to add another timesheet, like to 431 Trussell Road and log my time here, you'll see within here that this essentially has it filtered to the jobs for the logged in users as a subcontractor. So in the back end, say for example, Charles did the weekly mowing on 10-4. Charles would need to be logged in to this timesheets view in order to see it. So let's log in as Charles, and you'll notice that I log in within here, go to my timesheets, and then it should pop up right here. Yeah, 10-4 weekly mowing. I can click on it and get more details on that timesheet as well. And then clicking once again, I can go into this job in the back end too. Now you might be asking, what does the project management side of this look like? What do the project managers see? It's a great question. Let's take a look at this from the magic link. So if we click on this and go inside of there, we can see a dashboard as well. And our dashboard is going to show all the outstanding timesheets. If I click on one of these, I get the same info that they see on their end. For the job section, if I click on any of these jobs, I see the same information that the contractors would see. However, I can't submit a timesheet. I can press see all though to go check out their different timesheets, which would be over here. And this is going to list out all of the different timesheets rather than just show what was for the subcontractor that I am, because I'm not a subcontractor in this context. But if we went to the timesheet page, took a look at the filtering once again, there's an OR function here. And this is going to show jobs is one of the logged in user jobs as a PM. So this essentially means that for whatever job that I am the project manager and logged in for, if I scroll over here, I then am going to see it. So since Sophie is assigned to all of these, it would then show for all of them. But say, for example, I were to remove her from job number 9 here, right? Which is in West Bloomfield, 357 Charles Road. All right, let's get a refresh. And if I type Bloomfield, it's not going to be within here because I'm no longer the project manager if I'm Sophie. So that's essentially taking her out of that. And if I had different project managers, it would only showcase what things I would be project managing from a timesheet perspective. And when it comes to filtering, the same thing when it comes to jobs on this view is for subcontractors where there are jobs that they're attached to on the top. And then on the bottom here, we have another filter for if the project manager is logged in and they are attached to these jobs. The difference between these two blocks is that they are set to a visibility limitation so that subcontractors can only see the ones that are filtered to subcontractors that are logged in. And then this one is filtered to project managers that are logged in as well. And then the difference on that side is that since I'm logged in as a project manager, I have this extra view for assigned is yes or no to see whether those things are actually assigned to a subcontractor or not. You'll see subcontractors are here, assigned. If I put no, then essentially this would showcase the projects that aren't assigned to anybody, which is not the case. They're all assigned. And then both of the subcontractors and project managers can check out the status of all the different projects and filter to the different states as well. See what hasn't been paid, see what has been paid, and everything in between. If you like this video and want to check out more on how to improve at your skills using Softr, make sure to check out videos like this one right here.